for ngaitahu, a highly modified landscape means loss of habitat, loss of species that are significant to our traditional life cycle that is mahi ngakau.
We really have really only a few remaining populations, and these are the kinds of species that, you know, make our regions totally unique. You know, Canterbury mudfish or kōwaro are found nowhere else in the world. They're what makes Canterbury, Canterbury.
The barrier itself is not a concrete structure or anything. The barrier itself pretty much just uses railway irons anchored into the ground in a gravelly part of the local of the stream, and that creates an electric field in between. What that means is very little intrusion in it of any kind, but it stops predator fish from coming upstream. What that means is the electric field itself is so inconvenient to the fish but doesn't harm it, that it literally just knocks on the door and then realizes, oh, I don't actually want to go into that door.
We work with the American company, they supplied the fish barrier, but we've been involved with modifying the design because the New Zealand conditions are quite a bit different from America. As far as we understand, although there's been some other smaller fish barriers in the country, this is unique in the scale of the operation and the design of it, and also the fact that this is the first one as a standalone project where it hasn't been run off mains, where they've relied or we've relied on solar energy to provide the sole source of energy for the system.
You know, there's trust amongst the partners, and so it was a really easy decision to come on board when we see a solution like this, which is really practical and really tangible. Like, farmers can really relate to this. It's an action we can take right now to help the environment. It's not just talking and planning.
To see this today to come to fruition on an active working farm here in Canterbury, with all the parties that have been involved, is super exciting. It sets a precedence that actually this isn't scary. It's an opportunity to capture all values on property that bodes well for the future of all New Zealanders.
It's always been and really enjoyable coming here each year to visit and check the population. And I think this is a real credit to the landowners. They're nearly as keen on mudfish as I am. So we'll do annual monitoring here at a range of sites. So we're intending to monitor the populations above the barrier, where we've got quite a good data set over the years, but we've also set up the site below the barrier, so that's going to be a really interesting comparison to see how the mudfish are at sites where trout still are.
We've now got a unique opportunity to look at how the population develops. First of all, it's protected, and secondly, we can look at how quickly it increases, which gives us almost like a nursery for other areas where we can reintroduce them.
It's one intervention in one place. It's actually going to create 8,000 square metres of protected habitat. And that's the kind of exciting thing.